Her name is Maribel, but everyone here knows her as Kitty. She's had to endure living and working on this garbage dump for as long as she can remember. Each night after the trash is dumped here, the little girl scurries to pick up as many plastic bottles as she can for her grandma to recycle. Sometimes she also finds a scrap of food or a discarded toy to play with.
I don't like to live here. When my tummy hurts, I pick up food at the dump and eat it.
This is Kitty's grandmother. She told us how Kitty came to live with her.
Kitty's dad is in prison, and her mother abandoned her. That's why she lives with me. It is pretty hopeless for us.
Then we saw where Kitty and her grandmother live, right here in the middle of the dump site. Grandma is especially concerned about the rats.
I am afraid that the rats bite Kitty or one of the other kids who live here.
So CBN decided to help Kitty and her grandmother. First, we built them a new house, far from the sights and smells and the rats on the dump. It was an exciting day when Kitty and her grandma got to move in.
It's so good to have this new house.
Next, because CBN moved them far from the dump, we knew that grandma now had no way to make money to support them. So we set up a small clothing business for her right in the marketplace near the new home. Already, Grandma's income is better than she ever made working at the dump.
I'm making good money with my new business.
Then we were able to help Kitty to attend this school run by Christians. Here she receives a good education and hot, nutritious meals during the day, thanks in part to a new kitchen provided by CBN.
I like to study here. I want to be a doctor when I grow up, so I can help others.
Finally, during a summer Bible outreach for all the kids at the dump, which was sponsored by CBN, Kitty prayed and asked Jesus to come and live in her heart.
I'm so thankful for Kitty School, for the house and the new business. But mostly, I am grateful we don't live at the garbage dump anymore. Thank you, Operation Blessing.